so thanks everyone for joining. Merci à tout le monde qui sont de passage aujourd'hui. I'm going to be working on the Grey Tones, my comic book. So I'm going to be working over inks that are already done on the fifth chapter. So let's get started. This is actually a test page for the brushes there that I imported, because I actually discovered recently that you could import brushes from Photoshop directly into Clip Studio just by dragging and dropping, actually, which is great. So I was just testing out the gray tone brushes that I had customized for myself on Photoshop. Okay, so let me just put the volume down a bit, because it's I have this Facebook music blasting in my ears. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. Already down to one. Okay, great. So that's a bit better. If it's not, there we go. I'll put it a bit louder for you listeners. All right. So if ever it's too loud, not loud enough, feel free to just tell me in the chat. I have it open there for everyone. So, all right, let's get started. So. Generally what I'm going to try to do is I'm just going to open up there what it's supposed to look like. So let's go ahead and okay, so I don't have any here. Wait a second. Sorry about that. So the look we're going to be going for is something similar to this. So this is from the first chapter of the comic book there. You see those nice little gray tones. So I'm going to be trying to, I want to keep that same texture that I had. That's why I worked so hard on getting those Photoshop brushes into Clip Studio. But I'm going to try to go for a more blown out look. Like if, you know, not a concussion, but if you're getting like a, you know, shined a bright light in the eye and you can only see very hard whites that fade into black very quickly. So that's the look we're going to be going for. Let me open Clip Studio. Let's just say this guy. It's kind of Cthulhu priest dude. So I'm going to go in cold, which is not something that I would usually recommend, but I did draw a bit earlier today. I painted over a sculpt I did this weekend, so I don't need necessarily to don't need to warm up necessarily. So okay, now this might be a garbage fire because this is the first time I'm gonna attempt doing the grays on here. So first I want to create mats for all the layers, for all the items which are like kind of outline shapes of the items, so that I can fill them up with gray tones. So since that isn't the most interesting thing to watch, I'm gonna try to do it relatively quickly. So you know, I wasn't a fan of this Facebook music, but it's actually not too bad today. I had to switch from an app I really liked to the Facebook Creator Studio, which in my opinion doesn't have tracks that are, you know, the tracks aren't as good, but you know, they keep me from getting muted across all of Facebook while I'm drawing, which isn't the best, because you know, sometimes what's going on screen isn't super interesting in between things. So it's fun to have that music in the background just to help keep the viewers entertained. Okay. So my writer actually wrote to me today. He was like, oh, do you have anything new to show me? And I was like, no, not yet. Or Monday. And then I told him that I'd probably be streaming if he wanted to come and watch. And his response was pretty much like, yeah, I'm already going to be in bed at this hour. Power to you. Okay, great. So We have that white in here. So this is just to be able to work on the outlines. Let's see, there's my brush. Sorry about that. Okay. Okay. Great. And usually I'd be more conscious while drawing it so that the line is full and I don't have holes there, so I don't need to do this type of thing before actually getting started on those gray tones or those colors, but this style was done a bit haphazardly, and I kind of ended up not closing a lot of my lines, so that's why I need to do this now. Hopefully it won't be like this for every page. I'd like to be able to do more than one tonight in the best of worlds. Okay, great. So again, the double tap to erase on the iPad is a pretty cool feature, you know, since you don't have that, even if it's a $200 pencil, you do not have the eraser tip like the Wacom that actually comes with the tablet, so that's always a bummer. You know, you buy like a $1,500 tablet and you're like, oh, cool, I'm gonna be able to draw right away. Nope. That's not how it goes. To get that Apple pencil. Okay, great. So, I'm just gonna name this real quick. So. Perfect. So, I'm just gonna do a couple of these. Do one for that. Do one for the. Do one for the paper that's flying around. Interesting. Shrink selections. Okay, lasso. There we go. Sorry about that. So this is actually set to driving music because I listened to their chill beats last weekend. Well, last weekend. 2 days ago. While I was working on the Snuffle sculpt, the dog from Rick and Morty, and boy was that music boring. Jeez. So, I thought I'd change it up a little bit and switch over to some driving music without any vocals, of course. Turns out it's pretty good. The shape like this. See, this one I could have just filled it in actually. This Clip Studio has this really nifty, look at me sounding super old, nifty feature where you can fill in shapes directly by using reference layers. So say if I had to select paper selected, I want to fill this in. There we go, bang. I have a couple of these like, nope, see there? That was a mistake. There we go. See, this one was supposed to work. It did not. Okay, let's go back to the trusty pen. Or brush, actually, in this case. The bleed there past the inclines isn't too much of a big deal because it does sometimes give a nice effect. You know, in my mind, this page was full of paper, but there's like four of them, so. You know. See, and actually, I do this, there we go. Okay, that's already much quicker. Perfect. So if I turn this back on, it doesn't look like much has changed, but I tell you, world of difference. So if I put this back on, maybe even. Pardon me, that's gross. So what I wanted to do as well is have a big gradient on the background. Let me just show you. I did do a little sketch for the gray tones. So if I didn't can it, I should still have it. All right, here it is. So yeah, this is what hopefully it'll look like just better. So if I go back to Clip Studio, I can actually just switch between that. So that's what I want it to look like. This is just a quick sketch there to try and get that blown out feeling. So I do want those lines to fade into gray in the background and to have this nice kind of double gradient in the sky. So right away I can take the sky layer here, select the gradient, and actually just, okay. Interesting. So foreground to transparent. Now that's not what you want. What if I... Okay. Wait a second. Something happened. Sorry about that. Okay, let's go back. Oh, don't tell me. Okay. Well, so let's just save this, because that's the first time that's ever happened, so let's just keep going. Over restore canvas. Yeah, this is pretty much what I want. Should be good. Okay. So at least the paint bucket's working. Specified color. Okay. So. Okay. Now. Perfect. Now we're in business. Okay. Sorry about that. Actually going to take my line work over here, so these inks, I'm going to make a raster layer, clip it to now it is funny that I can't So then I can just, actually that's not what I wanted to do. So I want to put it back to a circular one. Just go ahead and kind of just add some depth into those lines. So probably not the main character. Put it right on top of him. Go and do this. Perfect, and then, because I want to keep the character kind of a more of a focal point, just draw blacks back into his lines. Just already, you can get a feel of depth in the image. All right, and then probably go and correct that matte a bit. I drew it, the light was coming kind of from the right side of the page. So let's go ahead and try to make something interesting. Alright, actually, I'll just go right ahead and start. Now the plan was to make my zones. Drawing your grays like this. There we go. Okay, and you do not want to do it on your mat, because your mat is, it's just to keep, it's like a background for the color of your elements. So I'm just going to make another, probably a vector, actually. No. Not a vector, because vector you can't use the fills, very important. So flip that to the mat of the object, go back to the brush. Okay. I told you it'd be a dark garbage fire, so okay, c'est ça. Donc là je peux finalement commencer là, les gris sur les bâtisses puis la rue. Okay, ça c'est la première fois que je m'installe là, pour faire ça sur ce chapitre-là. Chaque chapitre a un style un peu distinct. Ce qui était. C'est ce qui garde ça intéressant en dessinant. So each chapter has a distinct kind of visual style for part of the book there. Until it was also mostly for, you know, personal exploration. It was fun just to try out different styles, but it also reflects what the character is going through and try to give a different feel to all the chapters. Like it is, it's a partially black and white book because, like, say if it has 12 chapters, well there's like 6 pages of chapter 2 that's in color, just to hammer home there what happens to the character during that chapter. I thought that was a really cool way to work in emotion by changing the style of the comic book itself, just to fit the personal journey that the main character is going through, or the character that we're following for that specific chapter. Which is another thing that's fun, because it's really hard to pinpoint what type of comic book it is, because it jumps around from style to style and from event to event. It has a real nice feel. It's not a typical superhero comic, that's for sure. Which is funny, because when I was young, I was known as the guy who would only draw comic book characters. So it's a nice change of pace. There we go. Maybe even add some like detail. So the goal here is to make like flat shapes for the different gray tones, and then I'll just kind of fade them into one another. Using my trusty tone brushes. So it's already looking pretty cool. Another thing I really like about Clip Studio is their brush kind of, I wouldn't say algorithm, because that's just trying to sound super smart, but just the way their brush engine works. It's really interesting. It works very differently than Photoshop's. It's just as, or maybe even a bit more powerful, because they're so good at keeping that file size really small. Now the goal here is also not to lose that drawing and not to add too much to lose that kind of blown out feeling. I worked so hard on trying to get the right aesthetic and letting myself have fun there with how much to show and how much not to show while drawing it. So you don't want to ruin that by adding too many grays. So essayé de garder les contrastes intéressants, là, même parce que les tons de gris, en soi, ça l'enlève, les contrastes que tu as entre le noir et blanc. Fait que d'essayer de garder des contrastes intéressants entre les objets, puis pas que ça soit trop plat, puis que ça ressemble à un dessin de plomb. Parce que j'aime tellement ça, l'esthétique un peu Sin City. Donc de garder cet enjeu-là là, entre la lumière et le noir, puis jouer avec ça, c'est toujours été quelque chose que j'ai vraiment aimé. Fait que je veux pas perdre ça là, en mettant des tons de gris. So I don't want to lose that nice contrast or that some of the Sin City effect by adding too many grays, just to keep its character. See those white like those white window panes and stuff, and that kind of thing. I want to keep it because it looks so cool and so much more graphic, and having all those reflections, though it is, you know, not that they're not nice, the reflections do add something, but just to keep that contrast there, just to showcase the art in a different way. Fun also is to have repeating shapes, just a repetition adds so much to like scale and depth, so to repeat that with shadows is always interesting. So here it's kind of like if, you know, there's light coming from the top right of the comic book, but of the comic page, but there's also kind of almost some light bouncing off for, or almost light emanating from the character, kind of, you know, thematically could create this nice effect on the building that's beside him, just to keep the shadow work less monotone. So the writer was actually like, no, don't add, like, be careful not to ruin what you did. Yeah, don't worry. Try not to. Try my darndest. Always. Also, fun to add some cracks here and there. Also, if anybody has any questions or, you know, things I want to ask, or comments, criticisms, insults, what have you, feel free. So, whoa. Okay. So that's one thing I kind of... Okay, I think that's how it went. Kind of like stuff that's over kiosks, so it's already starting to look pretty cool. Again, this is kind of the whoa. Okay, boy, my iPad's acting up tonight. Okay, so this is the kind of look we're going for. This is a small sketch I did in Procreate. And, okay, so this is gonna be the final product there. It was done on a file. It was a way smaller size, just a space where I could try stuff out, throw stuff at the wall, see what sticks. not to do this on a full-size canvas and, you know, deal with the, either the lag or the space that this duplicate would cause. There we go. See, that's one of the beauties of making a mat. You can kind of fill in like that and back. There we go. Pause. I'm just gonna put on mute for a little sip of coffee. So it's looking pretty cool, though. You know, I did notice that this spot right here kind of has a lot of detail for something that's just supposed to lead, you know, the eye to this character here. So either I'm gonna tone down those grays way back, or just remove it altogether, because it's not adding anything. It's actually confusing the eye and keeping it in that corner, which is it's not what you want. So let's continue editing these grays slowly but surely, giving these nice black lines some friends. Everybody needs friends. Color this in to lose some of that complexity. There we go. Already. So I think that this tone of gray, we're pretty much done. So what I'm gonna do is just add another one. Oh, wait a second, add another one. Set it to clipping layer, put it underneath, and maybe choose a gray that's slightly lighter just to make things that are more in the distance. Add value to these buildings right here. Again, just try not to have too much high contrast around your main object, just so that the eye can really focus in on where the artist wants it to go. So even, see, I haven't had my fills on a different layer than the line work, and you can kind of see some weird artifaction. So what I'm gonna do is take these, where are they? Okay, these fills here, bam, and kind of just put a small gradient in it. Okay, let's use this bad boy here. Just see, now that's not what I wanted. Just create a new layer, clip it to this. See, there we go. See, so kind of fading those shadows into the distance, which is nice. Okay, great. So save again. Always save. Very important. So this is cool, and you can also see that. On the lines. Again, I didn't name my layers. Which is a big mistake usually, because now you see I made a mat. Okay, I took the time to make a mat for the paper and did name it, so let's go ahead. And put that right underneath the paper. Interesting. Okay, great. And I actually missed a piece of paper, so I'm going to take that paintbrush. There we go. So if I go ahead and remove the building match, you'll see that I kind of painted in that piece of paper there that was missing. And probably even with that second gray tone, add a shadow for the paper. There we go. So you can feel that it's kind of lifting off the ground. And really add some nice movement to it. This way. This is one of the nice things when you work digitally. Let's do this like this. If the writer gets his wish to, I'll be doing one of these, one of the chapters traditionally, which I wouldn't necessarily hate, but it's, I don't mind doing the drawing traditionally. It's after you've done the drawing, bringing it onto a digital canvas. That's usually where the problem is. So kind of just it, like that ledge was giving off a shadow, and that's kind of bringing it back to this darker line here, and then bringing your eye right back to the subject. So again, just trying to kind of have to be the tour guide and constantly bring the viewer's eye where you want them to go. It's, you know, done in different ways. In ink drawing, it's with line width and texture and rendering. If it's like digital painting, I'll mostly do it with detail and color. Okay, so it's starting to look like something. I like it. I don't know if anybody watched the Super Bowl trailers yesterday, but boy, that Falcon and the Winter Soldier trailer was awesome. I really liked it. Can't wait to see that show, because WandaVision is killing it right now, so can't wait to see what Marvel has in store for us next. Okay, I'm just going to take a small break. My cat's trying to break out of the office, so I'll be right back. Okay, so we're back. Just had to let the cat out. Alright, so I'm actually going to remove, so save, of course, always, and remove the crop marks. so you guys don't have to see them while I'm drawing. There we go. Something I did in the last one, and I kind of forgot to do it on this one. Okay. Just saw that I got this line here for some reason. Just gonna remove that. Since. There we go. Tonight. I'm happy because I was real bummed out that I couldn't use Pretzel Rocks, which was the other app I was using for the music, which has some really cool channels. So probably just going to keep it to two gray tones. Kind of liking the look. There we go. Okay, fait que sûrement juste deux tons de gris, puis je devrais être correct. Commencer à mettre des valeurs là-dessus, puis après ça, espérément, passer à la prochaine page. That was not on purpose. Okay. Make sure that those windows pop. So just try to frame them in an interesting way. Like I babbled on about 15 minutes ago. So again, that's kind of like repeating the curve of the piece of paper. So that's looking kind of cool. Alright, so let's go on to just to put a bit of gray tones on those pieces of paper that are flying around. So new raster layer, clip it onto the paper mat. So that paper is actually on. It's actually on the inks. So let's just go ahead and there we go. Perfect. Again. Like, geez, did I color in any of these pieces of paper? little bit of depth to this one. This one. There we go. That's looking kind of cool. Perfect. So save again. Always save. Very important. Actually, this one might actually light the underside of it. There we go. So that's looking cool. Sorry about that. Okay, let's go ahead and save. And then, you know, I said two tones, didn't I? But I will add a third one. Okay, which is gonna be like practically white, just slightly off white. And very, very like about this. Yeah, something like that. Windows are white. Same for these guys. That's gonna be a pain. Okay. Maybe just these ones. This is also why, you know, sometimes you draw and you leave a lot of open ended shapes. You're like, oh, it looks really cool, and you totally forget that it's going to be a total pain when you if you have to go ahead and go and color it. Just sometimes you can add yourself a lot of work just because of that. It looks so dang cool. Sweet. Okay, just go ahead and finish these, and I can actually get to working on the tones. And then I'll leave the sky and the some wind effects there for the end, because that's the fun part. Yeah, so it's looking pretty cool. Kind of looks a lot like the sketch, actually. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and save that. Yeah. Okay, let's get started on the tones. Now, one thing that's really cool, go ahead and unlock. go ahead and lock the transparency. So that means that all the parts of the layer that are transparent are going to stay transparent. And now I'm actually just gonna select the color. There we go. Make it a bit darker. And then just add some tones like this. So I either want to fade it into like a slightly darker version of it. Or the opposite, just take the tone that's a lighter and go back on it. Just to help with that faded out feel. Or that blown out feel, sorry. And then we can already get to the other one underneath, lock that alpha, select this here. Really like these textures that I had done for the first chapter. Okay, it's almost too quick. Just like that, and then just go ahead and color pick that. I actually can use shortcuts or modifier keys. So I think I had mapped perfect. So I had mapped the picker to the Alt key. Because you probably can't see it on the feed, but you can actually push the screen to the side. And you have some modifier keys that pop up. So that's your shift, your alt, all that. So again, just trying to get that blown out aesthetic. Yeah, I like it. Try not to add too much and to keep that, see, so slightly. Save this slightly deeper contrasts. Okay, let's leave it at that. And I might even, just so that it's not so white, just bring down, do a tonal correction on the mat, and just bring it down ever so slightly so that it's not pure white. Here we go, just so that I can make some white items pop a bit more. So I might have to go ahead. So good. So actually, that again. Nope. Return to paint. Save. iPad's acting up, you never know. Okay. Just do this. Edit tonal correction. So. kind of liking this minus 22 on the tonal correction. Let's keep it like that. And go ahead and color pick that gray. And then just do some slight. Yeah. That way, I can go ahead and choose some white here. Always remember when you want to draw into the shape, not have it pass there. You gotta lock that, that opacity. Oh, okay, that's not what you want. Nice flat color on top of the character. So already, it's looking pretty cool. When saved. Go ahead and use go ahead and okay. So still not sure about how this is looking. Yeah, really not sure about how this is looking, but hey, let's continue, carry on. Keep these white windows just because it brings the eye right into the middle. I also took the care to erase them out of that second gray tone, so you know, let's not have that go to waste. So and so that's gonna be on top, right underneath the inks. Just want to add some white there for those straight lines. So. I was actually gonna add them darker first, but. You know, asphalt's gray, these are bright yellow, so kind of, if you want it to make more sense, make more sense, yeah, okay, perfect, So now the first one of these inking streams that I did like this was the first time I had tried out the new microphone setup, and I was blowing into the microphone super hard every like 2 seconds. Apparently it isn't the case, so just tell me if it is. I'll fix that right up. Yeah, so it's looking pretty cool. So just this. This is probably a smarter way to do this. But I'm just gonna go ahead and color pick this gray right here. Now let's actually go ahead on top of all those gray layers, add a new one, and just paint over some white where it's too noisy. Oh, wait. There we go. Just have that blown out feeling. Okay. Let's see now that. Need a bit of texture here and there. Reduce the brush size a little bit. There we go. So I'm actually glad people listening aren't commenting too much at the moment, because I'll be honest, I haven't checked them too well, so you know. If ever someone does speak and I miss it or I catch it like half an hour later, I'm really sorry. I can get quite into the process sometimes. And I'm even surprised I can ramble on like this. Usually I draw in complete silence, or I make these idiot sounding whooshing noises while I draw. So. See, that's not, yeah, and actually. It was just texture and detail that was missing a bit. Perfect. Okay, so I'm happy with that. It's looking pretty cool. Let's go ahead and save. Okay. And now go ahead and work on the sky. So I'm kind of going to do the same thing with the sky. Maybe try to choose cool. There's something there, but I don't know if... Wait a second. Nope. Okay, what if I make it a bit smaller? Too small. So I'm gonna kind of do the same thing with the sky. There you go. Just make layers. See. So I don't know. Yeah, you can kind of see what I'm doing with the brush there. Because every time I kind of move the canvas, I kind of lose the angle that I had. So. So want those strokes to be bigger the farther you are from your subject. There we go. Yeah, I might even probably won't keep these lines or make them a lot paler. So it is not the prettiest thing for the moment. Just bear with me. Oh, see, I did that right onto the gray layer, so. That's what happens when you work and you're not looking at your layers. So, just remove all of it. Okay. Make sure I'm not doing... erasing anything that I wanted to keep. Okay. So just go and hit those redos. Until I get to the sky. So. Okay, well look, let's keep it there. So create a new layer. Okay. Also try and decide I want these lines to be light or dark. So see, oh, see, there we go. That's even better. Smaller. Keep the lines there. So I love that anyway. Il avait été long à faire par ici. Cette ligne là. Okay. Just make it a bit smaller. Some negative space in there. So. There we go. Don't want to make those lines, those shapes too complicated either, because there is going to be texture in them. So, not the same kind of texture though. It's really going to clash with what's already in the page, which should give it a really nice dramatic feel. Okay, so see, when this starts happening, it's, yeah, that means that, whoa, just, okay, that means I can probably go to edit, and then you want to clear the memory, which will erase your undos and stuff, everything you've done past, so you want to be able to go backwards, but it should generally make it much easier to work on. this brush tip is just too big. Okay, yeah. Again, wrong angle, so. Draw the outlines of these shapes and then use the paint bucket because it's pretty. Some of the brushes, if you do it too much, you can kind of see artifaction on the sides, but this one should not do that. Again, thanks to the people who are listening. Oh, that sounded sad. Okay, there we go. Gonna have to be careful not to add too much unnecessary detail or noise, because you know, the gray tones on this page are starting to, the time is starting to add up. So okay, so this is pretty cool. So those thin ones, we'll probably just leave it like that, but even see what it looks like without the lines. Kind of looks cooler. Yeah. This is actually really just a happy accident in true Bob Ross fashion. So I wanted to have wanted to make some clean shapes, but I really didn't anticipate liking these. Strokes so much. So. This is also something that I'll be able to play with later in the chapter. Actually, there we go. Perfect. And on the big ones, I'm gonna add a second layer of detail. So do this, clip it to there, and then I have a nice little brush that I had configured for the smoke I was doing in the first chapter of the book. So let's go ahead and choose this. See, so it's a really cool cartoon smoke looking thing. See direction of pen. Yeah, it's not working. No. A directional line. Okay. So sorry about that again. So let's randomize it. Pen tilt. I put the angle to zero. Why is this working? Okay, flip. I want to flip. Oh, okay, see. You know, I'm almost thinking I should just, at this point, I should even just do it with that other brush that was really cool, so. Let's use that flat brush. It's not this one. Yeah, so this one. And then just work in some secondary detail. This is the amount of time this would take traditionally just to get those nice lines. Well, actually, I'll probably just do that with an actual brush. Goddamn, that's funny. The comic book actually does a lot of oil paintings, and he specializes in clouds. I'm really interested to hear what he's gonna have to say about these. So I'm really liking this. These strokes. It's adding so much energy. And some really cool lines. Let's see, I told you this would be the fun part. Nice swooping motions. Wild. Wild. There we go. Okay. Just keep it real simple here. Some of that negative shape too. Alright, you do not know what's going on. Well, very cool. So see how much like this adds to it. It's wild. And then even if I want to get crazy, I'm not sure if I'll keep it, but I could even go ahead and take some, add some tone into it. See, it's looking too much. Like if it's added on top, but what if I put it on here just so that it fades? See, no, again, I'm not liking it. I think I'll just keep it full like this. Looks really cool. Perfect. And I didn't want to have kind of the same thing going on, but in the foreground, really on top of the lines. So we can choose that. Okay, for a moment there, I thought I was muted for the past 11 minutes. Okay, so just take a little sip of coffee before continuing. So again, just switching through the sketch that I had done. Sorry if I screamed into your ears, and the final. So this was the sketch just to get the tones down, and this is the final. So even if I could technically do this here, so you should be able to see both of them. Yeah, I don't know if you can actually see it, but. Hey, thanks guys. So, yeah, it's looking pretty good. So even if I want to add some of that glare effect, go ahead and choose the gradient against the circle gradient. We don't want that. Or actually, see, just like if there's light reflecting off the paper, and then even just a really, really So again, thanks to everyone who was listening and who commented. Glad to know that people are liking it. J'ai bien hâte aussi là, de pouvoir montrer la BD finale pour releaser ça là. Currently slated fin 2021. Fait que tu sais là, c'est ça. Ça s'en vient là, pas mal complet. Je vais juste aller voir, il y a comme un petit spot blanc. Interesting. Must be on the white overtones. Ça, c'est ça. Juste. Non. Pas là. Ce serait ici. Et voilà. Ça me gossait. Sinon, il y a le glare de blanc par-dessus tout là, qui a l'air de. Ouais. Je pense que je vais gosser avec ça une autre fois. Puis juste aller. Oh! Peut-être même comme ça. Ouais, parfait. Donc celle-là, on va la considérer complète. Save. Parfait. Donc on va pouvoir passer à la prochaine. La page 2, donc celle-là aussi, tu sais, ils ont pas mal de job à faire. J'avais une couple de corrections à faire sur les personnages, donc je vais faire ça tout de suite en fait. I did have some corrections to do. On the characters, just real quickly, so let me just rename some layers, keep this thing spoiler free. So this one was good. Character and everything was nice. It's this character here that the hair is looking a bit small, and then the writer was saying that, well, his skull is currently too small, and if you look at the haircut, it's not his hair is too short on this page. And also, this line underneath his mouth was bugging the writer a bit. So let's go ahead and. Again, I'm gonna remove the crop lines just so we don't see those in the image. Sorry about the mic hit. Already that liking it better. Okay, so this here, let's see if I can, before trying to fix it completely or redoing the whole thing, let's just see if I can cheat a little bit. Get in there. There we go. Select his whole cranium, his whole head completely. Bam, bam. Okay, and then see if. See, already it's looking more like the character. So even if actually do this here, and get this one. Okay, yeah, perfect. So that's looking pretty cool. Kind of delete that. Then clean up some of the lines. And actually, so probably gonna not remove the black fills, but remove the background to be able to just work on it without any distractions. So this is looking a bit like a cluster F. Just keep it simple. The KISS method. Keep it simple, stupid. See, now that's looking cool. Okay. Great. Go ahead and close some of these lines a bit. There we go. This panel should be really interesting, because considering how much I like doing that sky on the last one, this one should be pretty fun to do. There we go. Yeah, so that's looking kind of cool. Perfect, so I can go ahead and do a mat again, like I had done last time around. And let's actually... So, character, or, you know, no, because that's, okay, so that's looking good, perfect, go ahead and flip it real quick, you know, if I had one critique, it would be that we're still missing some space here, so, maybe just gonna cheat again. So like this, go like this, and maybe even select this one. That's really just this. Oh boy, that's looking wonky. Oh, wait a second. So already, that's looking a bit better. Let me just remove. There we go. You know what, maybe not. So let's just keep him with a flat head. Just say that it's foreshortening. Okay, perfect. So, go ahead and get started on the first panel. There we go. So, first panel. Character, I have the white fill of the pages. Let's go ahead and make this, get a layer in the back. To help us make those outlines. There we go. This, okay, so the white fills, I can just write that in. It's gonna be paper. maybe even add the character in here, because we don't need it to be too complicated. So this is something, I think for the next ones, when I'm doing the grays like this, I'll have these mats, or these shapes, pre-done before starting the stream, because this is the most boring thing to watch, I am sure of it. So, let's go ahead. Again, I'm not hating the music, it's good tonight. It's pretty good tonight, there we go. Here. Perfect. Select white. Bang. Alright. On top of the black fields, why don't you? See, now that's interesting. Okay, so the fields of the character and the fields of the background, we're done on the same thing, so let's just go ahead and I was like, do I want that to be in a gray tone? Nah, just a straight black. And was even, wait a second. Okay, so there's this one here. Like that. And then his eyes, which weren't even done. So no, that was a mistake. Remember to select the reference layer. There we go. So now that's looking good. Okay, perfect. So as you can see, this was the sketch that was on top. Okay, let's go ahead and start with those grays on the background. So I want to make them pretty simple, and maybe even just to have some brush economy going on, which is that I'm trying not to use too many different kinds of brushes, not to just have your whole image kind of meld together and look like crap, for lack of a better word. And this way, might even have some shape language that carries over from the ground to the sky. Keep that window white like we did on that last page. Gonna continue the shape up to here, so probably just go ahead. There we go. Okay, it's conflicting with his coat, so. A little bit. Probably have the eraser be the same brush actually. It is not. So let's just go ahead and... page because of the brush tip I'm using. So yeah, I'm just trying to use that detail to lead the eye to the character. So going for one big shape. There we go. So this is gonna have a bit of a tilt. There we go. Not a tilt, but of a size variance. Good. For this gray, makes us ask, comment c'est pas pour ce gris là. Pas mal plus pâle, on va aller voir. Ouais, il y avait quand même une grosse différence là. Si je regarde la dernière page, dans le fond, dans les gris, c'est sûr que là on voit plus grand chose, mais tiens, entre le gris qui est ici et le gris qui est là, il y a quand même des pas pires de tons de différence. So there's, you know, there's a big difference between those layers of gray. So I think it's gonna, yeah, it's more like this one. And then just try and drawing some hills in the background here. These trees will not stay as dark as this either. It's gonna be a lot lighter. Perspective, but some depth. So here you have those caves that are kind of sunken in. Detail, not to spend too much time on stuff that you won't necessarily see when you're looking at the final image, because I'm working really close to this part, but it's like, you know, it's about this big. So, and it's not even the character. Usually you want to concentrate your efforts on the character, on the drawing especially. Well, that's not true. Never mind me. Pay no attention to the man behind the camera. In front of the camera. There we go. Yeah, actually, probably just fill this in. cracked kind of présentoir dans le milieu de la ville. There we go. It's looking pretty good. I'm gonna actually put that on underneath the other gray layer and then start the final gray layer on the background, which is this color. Yeah. I'll just add these shapes here. I should probably just color this in like that. Yeah. And probably even just to trick the eye into not focusing too much on the background. Probably not even put the third layer, those third, there we go. That kind of white, not so white. Maybe not even put it in the background, just so to make sure that the eye focuses on the foreground. There we go. So, and then probably gonna, you know what, no, probably gonna work on the, ooh, nope, work on the tones for every layer. Yeah, I'll do it on the same layer. So just lock in the opacity, go ahead and select the trusty, so it'll decustom three of those tones, perfect. So then you want to go ahead and get your modifier key, select the tone that's lighter. We'll even bring down the opacity just a teensy bit. Again, select this one, go underneath, lock it. Okay, that's the lightest one, that's true. I'm gonna make that a bit smaller. To it. Okay. See, now that's interesting. So I made it too bright. That's why it was looking off to me. So just select the right gray. There we go. Yeah. So we want those different grays to have the friends that are right for them, you know? Like this gray here, there we go. those trees. Where are they? There we go. Just alpha lock them. Or, no, you know what? No. Just to be safe of artifacting, do that. Go ahead and choose a gradient. That's not what you want. Those are the fills. Those are not the trees. There we go. So you want those to be those trees to be on top of their background, just so that you don't have lines going over them. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. Okay, and then maybe even just take a brush, a trusty flat brush, select something a bit lighter. Just emphasize depth even more. There we go. Okay. Yeah, it's looking good. Perfect. And then what we can do. Paper fills for one, and then just draw some way over here. So, oh yeah, that is white. I say that's crazy when the white doesn't look white anymore. Yeah, okay. Just dump the brightness a little bit. I can see that the whites are white. So, maybe just take the lightest gray. Yeah. So these papers flying around like that, this is actually the writer's idea to put them into the page. Because we did these storyboards. Must be almost must have started them. Almost like 6 months ago. Or. Nope. That's a lie. Even more. Let's say 8 months. 8 to 9 months ago, we did these storyboards and they stayed pretty much intact. Except for these papers flying around. Well, this part, at least. Some other parts changed quite a bit because of rewrites and such, but these first few pages, they almost stayed the same, which is wild to me. Because we've had a really good back and forth and changing a lot of things as they come for the comic book, just to, so that it fits the rewrites and just to make a more tangible story. But it's pretty crazy that like this part has stayed the same since I got the script. So just wild. Wild. Okay. See, so this isn't, it's not light enough. There we go. It's already looking better. So I don't know what that is. It's probably just don't know what that is. So I'll just leave that up to leave that like that for now. I'm just trying to, again, sorry, my voice cracked up there. Just trying to add to that line work. It's not taking too much away. Now this is going to bother me. What's that? So weird. So it's just a So again, that's where the black layer kind of comes in handy. So I'm trying to figure out what that David Bowie-esque thing in the background is. It's driving me nuts. Okay. Interesting. There we go, so sorry about that. Let's go ahead and jump back into regularly scheduled programming. So, are all the layers back there? We can see, I'm not hating the kind of gray tone in back. Won't leave it there though, but not hating it. It's still wild to me that those whites look gray. Must be the eyes that are starting to get tired. Worst. Okay, there we go. Oh jeez, what are these gross white lines on top of my grays? Horrible. Horrible. Okay. There we go. Select the Kazi white. I mean this one. Okay, yeah, that one. Perfect. So now I can start the gray tones on that too. Go ahead and take the gray tone brush, make it a bit smaller so it doesn't look crazy. And then select. So always bam, 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 lock in that opacity just so it. Okay, there we go. That's perfect. No, don't want to make it bigger, I want to make it smaller. No, again. Wow. particle size. That's what I want to make smaller. Okay. So again, I don't want it to be too small, because if it's too different from the page and back, from the background, it's gonna look weird. Though, eh. Okay, it's looking pretty cool. Look at that blow out feel. And the whites. Trying to choose, you know, which edges are going to be soft versus which are going to be hard. It's like I want to, yep. Okay, and this is what I was talking about for the grayish whites. So edit, total correction. Just make it a bit. I think it was 17 yellow. Okay. So. There we go. Perfect. This one. Okay, so this one. This, and then I want to select this. Lighter gray. Very subtle. Perfect, and then I want to go on top of it and have a white layer. So pure white with the flat brush. Just to put some accents. Okay. There we go. Find the right angle. So, you know, I'm not liking this. So I'm probably just gonna scale it back to when the whites were white. You know what, actually, probably just go ahead and do this, and then just go ahead and add some tones. go to this background layer. Okay, great. And now, on top of the background, just add a very soft gradient just to add to that blown out feel. Just to make that character pop a little bit. See, right there. So, very, very soft, but not really gradient. Perfect. So just, make sure that this one's locked in. Just add a bit of some white tone. Save. I don't think I've saved up to now. That's bad. Very bad. Wow. Already 2 hours. Is that right? Oh my god. You know, I can't tell. So what is it? 11. Probably just take a quick break, go ahead and refill my coffee, and then I'll get to the second panel. And after that, I think that... Okay, I thought I had lost some stuff. So, already. So this one, you know, they're going to be side by side. So already done this, and this one. So go ahead and save that. Perfect. Alright, so I'm just going to take a quick break, refill my coffee, take a sip of water, because I feel like I haven't done that in a little while. So, alright, be back in like 5 to 10. Okay. Donc, on va continuer. Donc là, I had just finished that first panel. Donc j'ai fait cette page-ci plus tôt. I done this page a bit earlier. And now, maintenant je fais celle-là. Je vais voir, mais j'ai juste spoté une erreur. Sur cette page. Just spotted a mistake on this page. Just gonna fix it real quick before continuing. There we go. It's fine. Perfect. So I'll save that. And then just gonna retourner à l'autre page. Donc là, déjà rendu sa deuxième case, ça l'a pas mal fini. Alright. Cacher les layers. La page, this is the pages, the fill for the pages. Là, on va faire. L'espace, la forme blanche là, pour mettre en arrière du personnage. Just do that, the mat for the character. There we go. Comme je disais, like I was saying earlier too, this is something I'm gonna do not earlier, but before the streams next time. Je vais faire ça behind the scenes, là, pour faire ça pendant le stream, parce que c'est un peu push. Et voilà. En dessous, prendre le blanc, fill it in. Oh. Okay. Fill that in, that's perfect. C'est parfait. On va juste prendre les noirs là, qui étaient ici, les enlever ou les copier en fait. Juste les mettre là. Et voilà. Parfait. Donc, tout de suite, on peut commencer. Just trying to decide if I'm doing the character first or the background. I'm gonna leave the sky for last. That's for damn sure. C'est ça, je garde le ciel pour la fin. Là, vois-tu, j'ai mis mes lignes de ciel sur l'arrière-plan. Ah ben, si bon. C'est pas grave. Okay, so I'm probably gonna start with that building. Go ahead and add a layer. I'll take my trusty black layer to be able to see mon calque de basité. Regarde voir qu'est-ce que je fais. On va mettre ici. T'as fait là. Parfait. Donc, on va fermer ça. Petite gorgée d'eau, petite gorgée de café. Le blanc pour la bâtisse, c'était ça. Okay. Bang. Voilà. ça blanc, puis là on peut commencer avec les gris. Bang, bang. Non, ça va pas être ça là, ça va être le plat. It's gonna be the flat one, right here. So, staying true to the shadows that were in the last page, just gonna go ahead and sketch those out. Don't need to be too detailed anyway. Vous allez être trop détaillé parce que ça va être un autre gris qui va être en dessous aussi là. Juste pas que ça a l'air trop sketch. Là. Just try not to make it too sketchy. Leave it like that for this one, even that's a bit detailed. So, right there, just like that. Interesting. There we go. So, we'll choose the. So, it's this gray. Yeah. This one. Maybe just there we go. Try to lead the eye. Encore une fois, merci au monde là, qui regarde, mais sûrement d'être passé. Qu'à faire ça devant l'écran, oui, j'avais mis montrer au monde là. Qu'est-ce qui se passe là. Ça, je peux avoir du input, des commentaires, ouais, t'sais, pour pouvoir démontrer là, pourquoi je passe autant de temps en avant de l'ordi. Fait que ça a l'air pas pire déjà là, that looks pretty good. But take this, select the almost light, no, not that one, this one. Ça va être ça là. Ok. On va faire une autre couche comme ça. Et voilà. Parfait. Donc ça c'est pour la. That's for the building. That looks pretty good. I'll do the character right away. Select this guy here. Go ahead and block in some shadows. Fait que c'est ici là que ça vient tout cas un petit peu. Fait que c'est des personnages en gros plan de même. Puis tu veux faire tes ombrages là. Tu veux quand même respecter. You still want to respect the line work that's underneath. désolé, mais il est pas mal silencieux. Hein. Commence à être tard pour moi. Second gray again. Déjà là, ça s'en vient pas pire. Je vais te faire un ombrage des cheveux. Je fais that hair shadow that I've done so many times before. Line work in the comic. Here we go, I'll probably add some. This and maybe even just there, that makes more sense. Perfect. Color this in. Ouais, ça, ça a l'air. Ça, ça makes sense. On va prendre le quasi blanc. Ça a l'air un peu drastique là, mais enfin. after this also. Une fois que les tourniers sont là. Et voilà. Hey, thanks, man. Mr. Brandon Chester. So, it just popped in there. This is the current page, the one I was working on last. I added some grease to that one, so now I'm currently doing this one. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and continue. So, like I was saying, it's looking a bit drastic, but once I get those tones in there, we should get tones rajouted. It won't look as bad. Okay, great. So now it's time for the tones. C'est le temps des tones gris. So I'm gonna add some, just soften up some of those shadows where I want more my soft edges to be. There we go. Maybe make that particle a bit bigger. Not too big. Let's go 300. Right there. No. Still a bit too small. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And then it's like the other one. Once I'm at this point there, it goes fairly quickly. Always make sure to lock in. Okay, at least. So lock in that alpha channel so that it doesn't go over. So that means that if I, oh shoot. Okay, so I'm gonna, just gonna go back here. Or else the overlay of tones won't work. So go ahead and lock the alpha channel. Select this one. So for some reason, I got the Christmas music going. I don't know how that happens. So, again, lock that off the channel. Go ahead and add some tones. Then go ahead and add some tones. Again, a big thanks to the people stopping that by. Merci au monde qui écoute. Always fun to have company. There we go. And then that final one. Happy with all these. Well, yeah, save. Always important to save while you're working. So that face is looking good for now. I think I'll stop touching it. Alright, go ahead and work on the building that's in back. So again, alpha lock. Maybe actually for the background, make the particle a little bit bigger, which would be like the brush tip or the texture. If we're working on Photoshop, this is a Clip Studio paint on iPad, as the title says, actually, so I'm being redundant. Just adding some texture a little bit. There we go. Again, just trying to center in which edges are hard versus soft. One. Bam. We're almost at the sky, which is the best part. Sky. Going up over ciel. Let's go and select a new one. Okay, just see how I did it. Yeah, so there was a gradient there. Perfect. Let's do this. So make this full. Wow, it's not looking good. Okay, and then go ahead and get some gradients over there. I think that's looking cool. We'll create some sort of movement there with the back. So granular layer. Again, go ahead and choose that flat brush. It's been really good to me tonight. Okay. Make it big. Make it big. Again, this time I might not have the luxury of erasing the lines that I did on the sky, so I might need to try and respect them. I'll be able to recreate what happened on that last, on that other page, because it was a really cool effect, but it was a complete fluke. So it's looking good, it's looking good. screwed up the angle. So, okay, there we go. So always save from time to time. Always a good idea. So that's not too, that's pretty good. So let's go ahead and save, maybe, because I'm always scared of losing it, and I like working non-destructively. Probably just copy, paste that line work, and then would you copy, BG No Sky, there we go. You go ahead and remove skylines. Again, one of the great things about the Flip Studio Paint is that when you're working on a vector layer, you can erase that whole line just by flicking. Look good as they are, which ones could be used for negative space. And then probably, so what I had done now, that other place. Okay. Perfect. So take a really dark one. Maybe even lighten up this background a little bit, because it's looking a bit dark. Nope, that's not what I'm gonna do. Wonky a little bit. Thanks, Mr. Ceros, the mask maker. Okay, let's go in again. So, trying to get what was happening on this sky right here, this thing, onto the background of this. So, just get some tonal correction modifications over here. Invert. Make it a bit darker, lighter actually. Yeah, just make it a bit lighter actually. Okay, great. And then select one of the darker ones, maybe make it even a bit darker. There we go. And then go to work on top of this one. Make sure that the angle is working. Thinner, a bit smaller. Okay. Okay, bud, stay here, stay here. See, that's a bit too small. fill in. Oh, no, this isn't white. Go ahead. So it looks better as negative space, especially with the darker lines like that. This big one here, just to add some. There we go. Some crazy detail. That white was looking a bit lonely. So again, so it's getting a bit hard to read. Probably just overworking it. But it's gonna stay like that for now. Probably just maybe erase a bit of it. Yeah, just find a nice balance. So that's looking pretty cool. Let's leave it like that. So let's just add a bit of gradients, so the image reads better. So let's go ahead and put one on top of everything, just to get that blown out feel. Everything except the lines, probably. Lines and the blacks, I'll put it on top of the blacks too. That's looking good. And then we can probably just duplicate this one. Okay, and then just put it behind the character, which would be here. Nope. Here. There we go. And then we can just get to work on this one. Kind of just bring back there that gradient that was here at the top of the page. I keep pointing at the screen like you can see, I keep pointing at my tablet like you can see what's going on. You can't see that part of what's happening, so that's looking pretty cool. Maybe add some glare coming off those pages, and then I think I'll call it. Not liking it, but you know, white fill of those pages, so probably just gonna add like a tone. Yeah, so just go ahead and and there we go, clipping mask. See anything of that? Yeah, that'll do it. Let's keep it simple. So it reads well. There we go. So I think that was pretty good for an evening. So if we look, we did this one, so let's save it. And this one, so it's in the comic book, they'll be a side by side. So Wonder if I could do it. Yeah. So. And, yeah, if you can catch it, there's actually going to be some pages that, yeah, let's do this. So. So there's going to be some pages that overlap between the two. So this one here is going to continue just so that the pages on top of the comic book kind of follow each other. And something that's really cool that I hadn't noticed, the skies kind of match up between both pages. So that's really awesome. So, all right. Well, thanks to everyone who stopped by to listen. Merci à tout le monde qui s'est arrêté là, à regarder. So, see you on the next one. And I can't find the stop button. So, give me a moment. Yeah, so catch you guys next time. Thanks again to everybody.